Well, today I'm going to be making a big effort to do some sandblasting using a little cheap gravity-fed sandblasting gun I bought directly from China, 20 bucks. I've used it a little bit, and with aluminum oxide, it does a super job. The downside of it is the container for the blast media is so small, it only lasts about 5 minutes. But on the other hand, that's about as far as my compressor will go before it needs to catch up anyway. So if I had something with more capacity, I'd still have to stop. The downside is, of course, I'm doing this not in a blasting cabinet, but out in the open, so the media ends up on the floor. Particularly with aluminum oxide, which is expensive, I would certainly need to sweep that up and sift it out and try to use as much reuse as much as possible. I've bought a couple of 50-pound bags of play sand from Home Depot. Unfortunately, it's damp, so much of what I do today is going to be to use a heat gun and a sieve to try to dry it out and sift out the particles that would otherwise stop up the gun. To do that, I may be using, will likely be using my Hover X1 drone, essentially it's just a flying camera, which will follow me around. And then some of that I'll do with a GoPro, but it's going to require a lot of editing to put it all together and make it make any sense. So this is the introduction of the video.
Well, to continue my video about sandblasting with a small little gravity-fed blasting gun, I have no video on that. The reason is doing that outside, the sand goes everywhere. And I didn't want to risk any of my cameras recording that, so I'm sorry about that. But at any rate, just finished sandblasting a the body of a golf cart. This was for a neighbor. It was in pretty bad shape in that it had been painted and flaked and had stickers put on it and taken off and whatnot. So it needed that be sandblasted so it could have a good paint job. So that took me about 4 hours. And that's with that little tiny gun. I happened to, it would go about 5 minutes before the contents of the gun, the media was exhausted. But as I stated in the earlier portion of this video, that worked out well because with my small little compressor, it needed to catch up anyway. So while I was refilling the gun and whatnot, it would catch up. So overall, I'm pleased with it. Now my compressor is a 2 gallon compressor, but I've got a 5 gallon auxiliary tank in series with that. So that if it weren't for that, the 2 gallon compressor would just not be adequate for the job. The other thing, of course, since you've got, even though it's a small gun, it the container on that holds about, on this one, this is the smallest I could find, by the way. Cost me $19. But it holds about 3 cups of media. The sand w works well with it as long as it's sifted and dry. I do not have a dryer in line on my pneumatic line for my compressor. I need to install that. You know, although I never had a clog with at all. Now, occasionally, toward the end, when it was getting empty, it would start spraying some water out. So, if it were metal, that might be an issue, but this was fiberglass. But I really no complaints at all. It worked. The function was fine. I'd have to tap the side of the gun as I was aiming it at the surface, but by doing that, I'd get right down to the empty. The chamber would be totally empty, so I really have no complaint about it. So if you're like me and you're going to be just doing occasional sandblasting, and oftentimes on stuff that's going to be too big to go into a sandblasting cabinet, it's ideal. And for $20, you know, I could say that the sand, a 50-pound bag of play sand, cost $5 at Home Depot. So, and I used maybe 20% of that bag. I doubt it was that much. The biggest challenge there, of course, is drying it. So, but what I found that the easy way to do that was to just pour it out on the driveway. It's sunny, and let the sun dry it, and then I would sweep it up in the dustpan and put it in a container, and then sift it and work like a champ. So I guess to sum that up, with my aluminum oxide, and I did use some of that. That's easy because it comes dry and it's very fine and it's very abrasive. A little of that goes a long way, but and I do sweep it up, so I use reuse probably about 70% of that. But I've got enough now, enough sand on on hand to sandblast. I don't everything I've got, everything's sandblastable, I guess. So anyway, I would recommend you try it. It's going to be a little aggravating because it's you know, having to stop, refill the container. If you have a really high capacity compressor, then go for something bigger. There are bigger models of that concept, the gravity fed thing. With maybe twice the capacity of what I was using, so you could probably go 10 minutes before we had to refill it. But as I said, for me, it doesn't make a whole lot of difference. All right, I hope you found that useful. It's at least it's an accurate summation of what I've found, and hopefully, it'll be some use. All right, have a good day.